I recently received a question from a viewer with two ovaries, but she only ever feels ovulation on one side. She asked whether it is possible that one ovary doesn't work. That's a great question. It also brings up some other questions such as, what does not working mean for an ovary? Is the side that you feel pain on always the side that you are ovulating from? Does ovulation switch from side to side each month? Stay tuned and I will answer all of these questions. First, some basics. Normally, genetic females are born with two ovaries, one on the left and one on the right. The ovaries contain a person's lifetime supply of eggs. Starting at puberty, the process of ovulation begins whereby an egg is matured and released from the ovary into the fallopian tube. Without the use of fertility medications, usually only one egg gets released each month. Eggs are pretty small, but they grow and develop inside of a fluid-filled cyst called a follicle. Using ultrasound, you can see these follicles in the ovaries. When the eggs are immature, the follicles are small. As an egg matures, the follicle enlarges. So, using ultrasound, you can determine which ovary a person is going to ovulate from each month. Generally, when someone asks whether an ovary is working, they are asking whether ovulation occurs from that ovary. Over 20 years ago, some doctors from France did an interesting study. They recruited 80 people with normal fertility who had two ovaries and regular menstrual cycles. Each month, ultrasounds were performed to view the ovaries. If the largest follicle was small, they did ultrasounds every 2 days. When the follicle grew larger, indicating that ovulation was nearing, they did ultrasounds every day until they saw that ovulation had occurred. In all, they studied over 200 ovulatory cycles. What did they find? Ovulation occurred from the right ovary 52% of the time and from the left ovary 48% of the time. Statistical analysis, however, showed that this was consistent with a 50-50 split. Alternate ovulation occurred 51% of the time. This means that if a person ovulated from the right ovary in 1 month, then in the next month, half of the time they would ovulate again from the right ovary, and half the time they would switch and ovulate from the left side. What if you ovulated 2 times from the same side? What would happen on the 3rd month? Again, there was a pretty even split between ovulating from the left and right side. So it would appear that the side that you ovulate from is completely random, just like flipping a coin. Doing some simple math, we can calculate the chance for ovulating from the same ovary 6 times in a row or 12 times in a row. Can you actually tell what side you are ovulating from without doing an ultrasound? Some women report pain at the time of ovulation. Another ultrasound study found that people reported pain on the same side they were ovulating from 79% of the time. 7% of the time, however, their pain was on the opposite side of ovulation, and 14% of the time, they couldn't tell. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. There doesn't seem to be a condition where one ovary doesn't ovulate, but just like flipping a coin, it is possible to ovulate from one ovary or the other several times in a row. Finally, you can't always trust your ovulation pain to tell you which side you're ovulating from. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.